Thank you. His Excellency Foreign Minister Abdullah Shahid, Ms. Zina Qasim, CEO of Fayawati, senior officials from the Ministries of Foreign Affairs and Gender, Family and Social Services who have joined us virtually, friends, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to join you all in inauguration of my home Fayawati renovation project. I was pained to learn about the outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic at Fayawati a few weeks back. We hope and pray that all those affected by this have had a quick and full recovery. India's first Prime Minister, Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru, whose love for children is well known, said, and I quote, "Children are like buds in a garden and should be carefully and lovingly nurtured as they are the future of the nation and citizens of tomorrow." However, not all children are privileged to have a family and a home. I deeply appreciate the human service provided by the management and staff at Fayawati by providing a conducive home environment for vulnerable children to grow and develop. India feels privileged to be associated with this project and to contribute to this most noble cause. The project has been funded under a total grant assistance of 200 million rupiah, which was extended in two different phases, to Maldives for projects which provide high value to communities. I see from the video that the grant amount has been well utilized towards creating a more welcoming area, upgrading the security system, building a veranda to create a play area for toddlers, painting the walls with child-friendly colors, setting up of common rooms furnished with computers and PlayStations, placing additional benches in the gardens, and planting trees in the gardens, procuring furniture, and so many other things which have contributed to make Fayawati what it is today. We hope that all these elements put together have helped create spaces and environment for children to enjoy something similar to living at home and have a positive impact on their development. Under India's grant assistance program, around 30 small and medium scale projects have been undertaken for implementation across the length and breadth of the country. I am delighted to share that 10 of these projects have already been completed and inaugurated. Earlier this week, High Commission disbursed about 11 million rupiah for 11 projects which are under different stages of completion. Since the beginning of this year, 3 projects have been inaugurated, and these include the Ekuveni running track in Male, the Hulumale Central Park, and the renovated arrival jetty in Hulumale. Fayawati renovation is the 3rd Indian grant project in Hulumale and 4th overall to be inaugurated in the last 2 months. In the coming days, we look forward to the inauguration of Rush 2 Coastal Protection Project, constructions of classrooms in Lohi and Kinola schools, strengthening inclusive education support units in schools in Gurudufushi and Formula, wetland parks in Faris Mathoda, and procurement of vehicles for Mali Correctional Services. These high impact projects constitute a very important dimension of the vibrant development partnership between our two countries. These projects are driven by the needs of local communities and are in line with the priorities set by the government of Maldives. Their implementation rests with the local councils and agencies and is completely in sync with the efforts of the government of Maldives to decentralize economic activity and socio-economic development. The project symbolizes the strong commitment of the government of India in supporting socio-economic development in the Maldives. You are all aware that on the health front, India has provided 200,000 doses of Covishield vaccine, which has been used very efficiently by the government of Maldives to vaccinate 40% of the population by giving them the first dose. Maldives was the first country to which India gifted the vaccine, and that too within 96 hours of the rollout of vaccines in India. To continue administration of the second dose, another 100,000 doses should arrive in the next few days in Male. I thank Minister Abdullah Shahid and his committed team at the Foreign Ministry, which has played a very crucial role at all stages of project implementation, from their selection, monitoring, to successful conclusion. In conclusion, I again hope that the overall brighter and cheerful ambience and the new well-equipped spaces provided through the Fayawati project creates a homely environment for the children, increase their sense of belongingness, and infuse a fresh new sense of hope in them. Thank you very much.